And I've been thinking about all the complex reasons why we're drawn to church at Christmas time. Some of us are here because our parents made us be here, or our children made us be here. Some of us are here because such a great shot at singing such great songs. Or we're here because it's what we've done all our lives, and we're kind of nostalgic. Or it reminds us just of our childhood. There are all sorts of complex reasons that we're here. And that's true for me, I know, as well as for you. And then I come on this night, and I hear the beautiful songs, and I see the beautiful setting, and I begin to feel why I'm here, and then I hear the gospel story. And I think that that's really why we're all here. We're all here because of this amazing story about two humble people, just your run-of-the-mill Joe Schmoes, who lived in a dusty little town, an unwed mother, carpenter for a father. They're told by an emperor who is far away and for the most part has nobody's good intentions at heart, that they have to go on this trip to another town, back where Joseph came from. Go, and you know the story about trying to find a place to stay, and then they give birth to this child in a stable. It's an amazing story. There isn't another story like it. And then it goes on that there are these shepherds, these scruffy shepherds, the bottom of the social ladder in Palestine in that day, who are out in their fields at night. They see some kind of vision. We don't know how many shepherds there were. I like to think that there were only two shepherds. And this happens to them, and then they say to each other afterwards, "Wow, did you see what I just saw? What do you think this is? Did that really happen?" And then they say, "Well, let's go and see if what the angel says is right." Go. They are stunned that when they get there and there's a child in a manger wrapped in swaddling clothes just the way it was told to them. They say a prayer and they go back, and that's the end of their part in the story. It is a story that has power of its very own. And without this story, if this story were not true, it would be hard to be very hopeful about our world. If, in fact, our fate and the world's fate were left up to us, it would be hard to be hopeful. But if this story is true, if, in fact, God becomes flesh in this little child, in this scruffy little town, to a scruffy little family, appearing to some scruffy little shepherds, and God comes alive to them, then God can come alive to us as well. God can come alive to everyone if this story is true. So we come to remember this story, and because when we leave, we are hopeful. This God who came comes. This God